So basically, what you do is you mark a target. You give them a 25% increased damage received debuff. And then you can leap that from your human form. And then you can leap on top of them in your worgen form using this heroic, so you don't have to use dark flight to do this. So you'll leap onto them, and then you're just going to pop inner beast, and you're going to go for that kill. Now, when you consider that this is 25% additional damage to all heroes, this is going to be quite good against tanks if you're really trying to blow up that tank. You don't have Tyrande on your team, but you want extra burst potential on a multi-warrior composition or something. This could be very valuable because that 25% increased damage received on that target is very valuable. This is also a 1 minute cooldown. Both of his heroics, they're just flat 1 minute cooldowns, and it's going to be really fun to actually see this element. But now that we've gone through the full rundown exactly what these are, let's actually just let this video play if you haven't actually seen it yet, and we can just take a look at exactly what how all these abilities look. So that's the Gildane cocktail. You can see it didn't really do much damage to Kerrigan. Wow, this goes quick. It did a lot to the Vikings. Then we saw his cleave going forward there. let's rewind this. It goes way too quick. I guess they're just trying to preview it very quickly. All right. So Gildane cocktail, again, this is right after it's been cast. You can see that it did a fair amount of damage to the Lost Vikings, not too much damage to Kerrigan. Like we said, at the base level, it's only 152 damage, and then 454. So very good for Razor there. That is the cleave, Razor Swipe. I mean, it's a little bit more damage. It's got a pretty big radius, as you can see. And it's just going to be pretty useful in general for... I think it's got a great length here in general, but... It's going to be pretty good for once you're closing the gap and just getting in there to do a lot of damage to a variety of targets. And you can see his auto attacks hit pretty hard. That's Rexxar's health pool getting chunked down there. Range attack auto attacks, not quite as strong. Inner Beast being cast there. It gets much more quick with those autos than Inner Beast here with his auto attacks. He just swipes down Sonya quite quickly. So he's very strong AA hero. There's Dark Flight launching on in, transforming into his Worgen form to close the gap into Leoric. The actual initiation of that ability, not doing a lot of damage, but this is, again, how you close the gaps. And then, of course, you can disengage after 6 seconds to get on out of there and go back to your human form and start throwing out your other abilities. Now, this is the first heroic to go for that heroic. Got him there, killed Illidan like Illidan. It was a sack punch, gobbled him up, and then he can cast it once more, and it does a good amount of damage. I mean, just like that, Thrall took about a third of his health, and then two more swipes is at half health. So Worgen is a hero that hits pretty, pretty darn hard. That's for sure. All right, this is marked for the kill. You see, it's got a very long cast range here. He launches that at Butcher, and then he can dive onto that target. Remember, this target will take 25% additional damage for 5 full seconds.